I want to find the guest journey at the Bliss Hotel, starting with making the booking. This is, everybody always thinks it's like when the guest is arriving. I don't think that's true. It's about when you make the decision to actually, you know, book this hotel. Hi, my name is Nadja, and I'm the co-founder and CPO of Roomaku. The reason why we actually founded Roomaku was to serve an own need. I took a leap of faith and I bought a small, beautiful boutique hotel in the Netherlands, about an hour away from Amsterdam. Well, that journey obviously came with some hurdles, and I'm super thrilled to take you along, share with you everything that I have learned during my 8 years of running a small, luxurious boutique hotel. I want to find the guest journey at the Bliss Hotel, starting with making the booking. This is, everybody always thinks it's like when the guest is arriving. I don't think that's true. It's about when you make the decision to actually, you know, book this hotel. That is when your journey starts. So after that, I think it's important to inform your guests well about everything. The hotel was in the city center, meaning in the Netherlands you cannot drive there by car, so obviously you need to inform your guests about that. Before Roomaku, I was calling every guest before arrival and explained them where they should park their car, what the costs are of this, what the check-in and check-out times are, so every day calling all of the guests. Now I think it's important to send pre-arrival emails that just do the trick for you, and you don't have to call them one by one. It's highly appreciated by those guests as well, and since then I never had the unpleasant experience that people were trying to drive into the city and then you already have a friction because they somehow have to turn around and then go to a parking garage and carry their luggage. So before they actually put a step in the door, they already had a bad experience, which is difficult to turn around. So when arriving, we had this beautiful hallway with this huge chandelier, so it was very impressive already to enter the hotel, and I think that is important. If you can make your entrance and your reception look fabulous, I think that is so great, and sometimes it's just fresh flowers. When checking in, I try to make the time that they spend at the reception as little as possible. So we obviously have now an online check-in, so I didn't need to collect any kind of data anymore. The only thing I needed to do is welcome them, which is the most important part. Then I let them put their luggage away, so I will always bring the luggage, and I walked with the guests upstairs. I went with them through the rooms, explained them the most important things. Then I went downstairs again to get my welcome drink, which is highly appreciated. I would recommend to do something like this. I did not have coffee machines in the rooms, and I also did not have a mini bar in the rooms. I did this because sometimes it's difficult to maintain. So I wanted to have a different concept, which I also thought really fit it to the Bliss Hotel. So I had an honesty bar and I got a lot of great reviews about it. So I just made a big fridge with also more special stuff in there than the normal mini bar. So I had a cooperation with a winery and with a shop, and had the greatest wines in there, small bottles but also big bottles. The small bottles, I took a lot of care that they don't have the screw top, even though that doesn't really matter for the quality, but I think it's cool to actually have a cork as well, even though if you only have a small bottle when you're a corporate guest, it just adds to the experience. And then guests could just, it was really cool. I mean, they met in the hallway in their little bathrobes. I mean, again, think about this, they're like high-level executive guests, right? Like rich people. And they're going in their slippers and their bathrobes to the honesty bar, and I think that was great. It just belonged to it. I did not have cameras around that as well, so it was completely full on trust, and they just told me in the morning what they had and what they didn't have, and that worked out great. So during this day, as it's the nature of the Bliss Hotel that it is more like with the themes, you spend more time in there. So my guests were, I made sure that there's a lot for the guests in the room. So water, of course, but also small little gadgets that they would just appreciate when they're going to the bathtub or something like that. So that was all about the journey then. Then in the morning, they could, because I didn't have coffee machines, they could call me or call the reception. I would make them fresh coffee that I would then serve them onto the room free of charge. In the morning when they come down, I always make sure that we are standing next to the stairs. So when they're coming down, that somebody is really walking, welcoming them, bringing them to the breakfast room. Always fresh eggs, use butter, not oil. Tastes much better. So the feeling of welcoming my very first guest, I still remember it quite vividly. First of all, our reception at that time, the physical reception, was kind of combined with the restaurant. Later I moved it to my own area, which is much better. It was, I felt, I did the process of how they used to work, and I felt already the friction, like, because I maybe have more the understanding of how it is to be a guest than how I was trained or how things are always been done or have been always done. So this guest registration card, I really didn't like that they had to fill in all those details. They were standing there with their suitcases, and yeah, I think that was not super nice. But then the feeling to actually bring them upstairs, obviously I carried the luggage and my high heels upstairs for them. That is, it's really, really cool. And then, yeah, just the smile on his face, you know, like, again, it might be a different concept that you are having, but even as a guest myself, if I arrive at a hotel, you want to have this feeling of relief that you have arrived and that now you just are there to unwind, even though if you are on a business trip, right? And if you manage to accomplish that, then I think you have succeeded in starting the guest journey. At the Bliss Hotel, we had very much corporate international guests, and that comes with certain things that you have to consider. So it is your responsibility to also be aware of the cultures and the customs that there are. But also just funny things can happen, right? For example, I had once a guest who came over from the States with a big jet lag. So he went to a very neat guy in a suit and everything perfect. But then I went home, and my colleague, she called me like in a little bit of a panic, and she says, like, there's this naked guy running around here. I was like, what's happening? So eventually what happened, she went then to the restaurant and asked like the chefs from there for some help, and they got this cooking, I don't know how you call this, but this cooking thing where then obviously the butt still sticks out. But this guy was sleepwalking, you know, which can happen when you are hosting international guests. And he apparently walked out of his room, went downstairs just completely naked. But the funny thing is also that my breakfast area where he went into was right across from the restaurant, which is complete full with windows. So all of those guests had like the pleasant experience as well to see him walking around without any clothes. But you also have other customs. People or guests from Asia, they value tea kettles, for example. Or when you have more corporate guests, make sure that you have ironing boards. If you have more leisure guests, make sure that you have the little slippers, pantoffels, to make them feel more at home. You can consider if you want to do a turn down service. I have stopped doing turn down services after some strange experiences there as well. So you might want to not do that. And then they could just order the eggs that they wanted to have. And next to it, I had a little buffet. Not too much. Don't make it a big one. Make it a good one. That is just the most important. And then they're checking out. And then afterwards, I sent a post-departure email just asking them for how their stay was, maybe for a review on TripAdvisor, but I also sent them a coupon code for the next reservation to hopefully turn around those guests that booked via booking channels to book directly with me the next time. In the first 10 minutes after a guest arrives are crucial. Hospitality is a people-to-people business, and having a smile on your face is probably the most important. There's I've checked into so many hotels where this simple little thing was not given to me, and immediately your whole journey is really like you don't have a feeling with a hotel. As the Bliss was all about feelings, journey and experience, we called it the 9 nightly escapes, right? So it's if you don't manage that, to have like the smile on your face, then don't even bother for the rest of the journey. So the first 10 minutes are crucial of your impression. It's also how you look like. So you, again, for me, it was important that they had wearing the suits and the tuxedos actually, and, that you don't have bright pink hair, that your nails are okay, because it's not, you're also being judged by how clean everything is, right? So, and that also belongs, also your own maintenance, well, serves this purpose, of course. It is important to also train your staff members to have the same ambition, right? Or the same way of how you would do it yourself. And I think what I did, and I would recommend that to everybody, my teammates had to stay over themselves, so have to feel the guest journey themselves every half year. So then they just experience it how it is. It's also very important for the housekeeping team, because all of a sudden you don't experience the room from the top level where you look down, but you're laying on a bed and all of a sudden you see all kind of different things that you might want to clean next time. That is what I just would recommend. Let them experience it themselves. How do you want to be treated yourself? And then transfer this to welcoming guests in the future.